Hello everybody, season 17 in Diablo 3 has launched, and of course I'm here to show you how to get through your seasonal journey, and of course get your awesome portrait and new wings and portrait frame if you're playing on PC. The first thing to mention as we jump into this is that they've changed the seasonal journey a little bit. Now, it's not that they haven't added anything like massively new. It's just that when you look at your seasonal journey now, unlike before, you can actually look into the future of what is required. So before, if you were on chapter one, you would only be able to see what was here on chapter one. Now you could see chapter two and so on all the way through, regardless of what chapter you're on. And of course, anytime, just like in the past, if you got credit for something that was on a different chapter, you would get credit for it and you wouldn't have to redo it. So that's always nice. Now, starting off with that in mind, in order to get through chapter four and get your 6-piece bonus from Hadrig's gift, it's really easy, just like it is every season. I'm gonna give you guys the same tips that I give you every single time, but once you get to chapter four, you will get all 6 pieces. You get 2 at a time, depending on your class set. Sometimes you have extra pieces in your set, and it'll give you 3 pieces instead of 2 out of the caches that you get. But overall, by the time you get to chapter 4, you'll get your entire set. You'll get a portrait. You'll get the first portrait frame for the season, which is a redo of a portrait from before. So they're starting to recycle those through, which is okay because it gives people the opportunity to earn ones they haven't earned before. And because it's on like, what, a 3-year cycle at this point with them having to go through all of the portraits, it still keeps them rather rare. But you also get the Wicker Pet, which isn't new either if you get through all 4 chapters. So again, there's nothing crazy here. 1 through 4, it's pretty much the exact same thing as before. Leveling up, you know, raising the jeweler up, raising the blacksmith up. You're getting all the way up to the point where you are hitting level 70. You're killing different bosses depending on, you know, every season they always have different bosses that you have to kill on different difficulties. And then this is where I always give the same advice. Once you hit like level 50 or level 60 in that area, sometime between 50 and 60, start going and doing bounties. Go finish every axe bounty because you're going to have to. You're going to have to do 1 through 5. Don't turn them in though. So you finish them, you get them all done, they're ready to turn in if you go talk to Tyrael in town, but you're not going to turn them in. You're going to get to 70 and then turn them in. The reason why is because once you pick up the bounty caches at max level, they will contain a ton of crafting materials and patterns. And this is helpful in finishing something in chapter 4. So again, this is how you're going to do it. Once you hit 50 to 60, go do all of the bounties, clear them out. I suggest this every season. Once you hit 70, turn them all in. If you're playing with a group, make sure they know not to turn them in or to reset the game. Like, don't reset the game. Keep all the bounties there. Go do rifts or whatever to level up once they're all done. Then when you hit 70, you go turn them in and you'll get everything you need for the 5 blacksmith recipes and the 5 jewel crafting recipes. The 5 blacksmith recipes you'll get right off the bat from like one of the caches, but you'll get 1 jewel crafting recipe per cache. So if you turn it in at 70, you'll get both of these done, and you won't have to worry about doing bounties once you actually are past 70. So it makes all of this a lot easier. Just as always, you have to do a greater of 20 solo in order to get the last piece. So to get your first 2 pieces, you complete chapter 2. It's basically hit 70 and then do a couple things. It's pretty easy. Then do chapter 3. This is, again, mostly just killing bosses and going through and doing the bounty caches, which you'll have most done, and then chapter 4, you'll do the couple boss kills. So in this case, it's Siegebreaker and Zoltenkuhl, and then you'll go do Greater Rift 20 solo. There's also something like reforge your weapon property to a socket at the Mystic. That can take a while. It's annoying. It is what it is. So before we move on to the other chapters, I am going to share a really helpful tip for you all. So imagine you just started your season. You're just jumping in, either on console or on PC, it doesn't matter. And this is the first time I've done this. Let's take us for a ride. We are going to jump in on adventure mode in Master. You first create your character in Master. And once you have your character created, do the challenge rift real quick. Just go get it done out of the way. It once you have the character created, though, not before, then you jump in on the character, and the change with this season is that the Challenge Rift bag gives you 35 Death's Breath, where it didn't before. So you'll get a ton of these crafting materials, you'll get the Act crafting materials, and you'll get 20 or 35 Death's Breath. Then go do whatever you want to do to level up to 10 or whatever. You can spend blood shards depending on your class. Some classes have items that you can get at level 1 that are really helpful. You'll have to look that stuff up. I'm not going to go deep into the strategy of, you know, how to start your character once you hit a first seasonal character. It's just this new thing. So you will have to, as you do every season, go get your cube as soon as possible. Some people like to wait until you have some kind of movement speed. That's totally fine. Just go get your cube sometime before like level 15. Once you get it, you'll have 35 Death's Breath. You can upgrade your crafters all up to max. Once they're max, you should be able to come over here and make a level 70 weapon. I'm going to show you the trick. So for demon hunters, you don't want to do a bow or crossbow. I mean, you could, but the easiest thing for you to do is to make a level 70 dagger, because you have two options for this. So you're going to, once you unlock your cube, you're going to come over here, you're going to pop it in, you're going to go to the third page, the third recipe, the Hope of Cain, fill it, boom, you're going to upgrade it, and you're going to get one of two daggers. Either you're going to get Carlisle's Point, or you're going to get, what is the name of it? Lord Greenstone's Fan. So depending on how it rolls, you may get like an ancient Carlisle's Point or Lord Greenstone's Fan that has a secondary of like reduced level requirement by 40. Then you really don't want to cube it. But if it's just a normal item, especially if it's Greenstone's Fan, you put it in the cube and you would go to the first, the extract legendary power. You put it in and then you select this on your weapon. So you would, depending on which of the daggers you get in this case, you would select one of these two, and it makes leveling way freaking fast. You do this with any class, not daggers. It depends on the class. You know, like crusaders, you'll do one-handed flails. Wizards don't really have many good options, but you can find some. But then, you know, like necromancers, two-handed scythes are really good. So that is the tip for getting started and leveling really quick this season. So once again, you're going to make your character, go do the Challenge Rift, open the Challenge Rift bag on your seasonal character, go and get the cube as soon as you can in Act 3, come back here, make a level 70 weapon depending on your class. You can research which one to get, then upgrade that rare item to a legendary using this cube, and depending on what you get, put it in the cube, extract it, and then equip it like this. So essentially, from leveling on, I would have 400% increased damage to Phantom Knives, stacks up to 30 times, which means that I can like one-shot anything once I get Phantom Knives at, I think, level 14. So, you know, some of these are really good, but that's the best way to jump in and get started. Let's go back to the seasonal journey. So once you get Chapter 4 completed, everything else is just fluff, right? Chapter, or it's the Slayer chapter, is you're getting a new portrait frame all the way up through Champion and Destroyer. But Conqueror has, on PC, a new stash space. If you've already maxed out your stash spaces by doing seasons for like the last 5 seasons or whatever, this is an extra one. So they give everybody on PC an extra stash space if you can complete Conqueror. And then finally, if you get Guardian, you get these freaking awesome cosmic wings. And it's not that hard to do this season, especially because it is the season of nightmares, which means as long as you don't have any set bonus from any other sets. You can wear other set items, but as long as you don't have a set bonus from any other sets, any ancient item you have will increase your damage by a stupid amount and reduce the damage you take by a pretty nice amount, which means that if you have like 5 or 6 ancient items, you're just going to be doing crazy damage. It's the Legacy of Nightmare set. It is a cool ring set, but is a passive effect for this entire season, which means that everybody will be able to get to Guardian if they want to push. So Slayer doesn't have anything too crazy. The main thing here is doing the killing Rakanoth, killing Adria, and then getting Greater Rift 30 solo. Outside of that, you can make sure that your cube is equipped with both a weapon, an armor slot, and a ring power or amulet power, whatever you want to put in there. For Champion, you have to level 3 gems to 35, and this is important because we're just going to skip ahead to Guardian. You're going to want to level 3 gems to 70. So just plan on doing that if you plan on getting to Guardian. Don't do anything else with those gems, just get them to 70. Then we'll have a special trick that we'll do for that in a minute. But then there's things like craft a flawless royal gem. You'll have to get the pattern for that at the jeweler in order to finish champion. Master any set dungeon. I say master because just finishing one is the requirement for Slayer. But the problem is just finishing it isn't going to really do you a whole heck of a lot. You're going to want to master it because that's part of this anyways. So get your set dungeon done, master it, kill the bosses, get to a Greater Rift 70 or 40 solo. At the end, you are going to want to get to Greater Rift 70. So as long as you can do a 70, once you do your first 70 solo, you'll get your first primal ancient item for free. They'll just give you one in your inventory once you, it'll drop off the boss, but it's really nice to get your first primal ancient item by doing your first 70. And then from then on, primal ancients, which are perfect items, will start dropping for you very rarely. Then, in order to get to Guardian, the other things that I would recommend is starting to fill up your cube with stuff. You have to get to 40, even though Conqueror has you doing 20, I think it is, or maybe it's the one before that. One of them you have to do 20, then you have to do 40 at the end. So just do 40. Yeah, it's Destroyer, it's the 20. And the little trick that I do is because you have to get 3 gems to 70, of course, I would recommend getting 3 gems to 70, and then for the Conqueror, you have to use Kanai's Cube to augment an ancient legendary item with a 50-plus gem. Just use one of your 70 gems. So get 3 of them to 70, and then use one of them to augment. That'll be the best way to do it. The reason why is because otherwise you would have to get a gem all the way up to level 50 and then do that, and you're going to get a less of an augment on your item. You may as well just use one of your 70s. So that's a little trick there. And the final thing is there are 2 boss kill things. There's Kill Diablo at 70 in under 1 minute and 30 seconds on Torment 13. They've added up to Torment 16. This is really easy. Like, this is ridiculously easy on Torment 13. Let alone on Torment 16. So any class should be able to do it rather quickly. If you're playing a Shadow Impale Demon Hunter like I am this season, you'll absolutely destroy Diablo, and 1 minute 30 seconds is just, like, that's an eternity based on how quickly you'll actually kill him. And I did it on Torment 16, so that tells you quite a bit. And then Guardian also has one to kill Malthael at level 70 in under 45 seconds on Torment 13. Again, if you're playing a big explosive class that does a lot of damage, this should be really easy for you to do. If not, just find a Shadow Impale Demon Hunter or any class like that that can just blow up a boss real quick and get it done really quick. Even with the transitions that Malthael does, it's not going to last 45 seconds. He'll die really quick. Then, finally, you have the conquests. There's 3 conquests that you have to do this season in order to get Conqueror. They're kind of annoying this season. Avarice is really easy to do with the addition of Torment 16. Just do the same way. Like, I have a guide that I'll put in the description. You can go watch how I did Avarice, and then you just put it on Torment 16 now if you have a build that can do that. And it's so easy. I've accidentally gone well past 50 million gold multiple times now that I've just been running Torment 16 Rift, so it's really easy. Sprinter is kind of annoying for people who don't really know how to do it or don't want to do it, but those who do can get it done really quick. Basically, you complete Acts 1 through 5 at max level in under 1 hour. This is really just, you could do it solo. It's way easier if you just have someone sitting in town turning in all the quests as you finish them. And knowing how the flow of each of the acts work really helps as well. It's just kind of annoying. It may take you a few hours to kind of get it down, but once you do, you'll forever be able to do it. Then there is the thrill, which is reach Greater Rift 45 solo without any set items equipped. Again, this is really easy. If you just have a couple ancient items on, your damage is going to be ridiculous. So just go do that. This is probably one of the easiest conquests to do this season. And the last two are also kind of annoying. So either you reach Greater Rift 55 solo with the full bonuses of 6 of the following class sets, so any of the class sets, which means you have to at least have 2 classes leveled up to 70 with 6. So, well, I would say 4 sets on one and 2 on another. So it's still kind of annoying. Or you go master 8 set dungeons, which is also rather annoying. Some of these are way easier than others, but I wouldn't suggest doing Master of the Universe at all. I would actually suggest doing The Thrill, because that's the easiest one, Avarice, and then either Sprinter or Years of War, depending on what time you have. Years of War would be really easy if you have a level 70 that you're already farming with. You just go, of course, get blood shards on your level 70 that you're farming with. Once you max out on blood shards, you switch characters, you spend your blood shards to try to gamble for set pieces. You just rinse and repeat until you have two sets on another character, then you go do that, and you use your four sets that you already have on your main character that you would have gotten by then anyways. Or you go do Sprinter and try to get that done. It's kind of annoying, but I'm sure you'll be able to figure it out once or twice. Some people are able to just one-shot it, especially with someone sitting in town turning in quests. So that's my suggestion for the conquest. Once you finish all of that, of course, and get to Guardian, you will have your awesome wings. It's as easy as that. Just remember, there's a couple things that you can do to make your life easier. The bounty trick when you're leveling up, the cube trick once you first make your character, if you haven't done that already, you can make sure that you get your 3 gems to 70 first before going down and doing the augment for the Conqueror. And then once all that's done, it's pretty much easy going. The rest of the stuff to get outside of the conquest will happen really quickly, and now that you can kind of scroll through and see what your progress is and on all of these, it makes it a lot more friendly to the average player. And I would say most players will be able to get the wings this season. If you have any doubt of what class to play this season to be able to do that, Demon Hunter has arguably the strongest start. Necromancers are pretty good this season, and so are Wizards, but that's not to say that Crusaders are really good for solo. They have Invoker set, so that's another good class to jump in and try to get your seasonal journey done, whether you're on PC or console. Just remember, PC players get that extra stash tab on the second to last one for Conqueror, and that's a pretty nice little carrot on the stick to go get, even if you don't want the wings, but you may as well finish them off because you're pretty much right there anyways at that point. With all of that being said, thank you guys very much for watching. I'll have more guides up for season 17, including class guides and build guides, coming up this week, but we shall see you guys next time.